Today I am going to present what is 3-inch arch, the types of 3-inch arch, and how to analyze the arch for static loading, and how to calculate the vertical shear, normal thrust, and radial shear in the 3-inch arch, and how to find out the bending moment at any point in the 3-inch arch. What is 3-inch arch? So already we have discussed in the last class, what is 3-inch arch? If the arch is present 3 inch, then this is called the 3-inch arch. So at two support, there is 2 inch, and at the topmost point, at the crown, there is 1 inch. So this is called the 3-inch arch. 3-inch arch is statically determined structure, and its reaction and internal forces are evaluated by static equilibrium equations. So already we have discussed in the last class, because in the 3-inch arch, there are 4 reaction components. So 2 reaction at support A and 2 reaction at support B. So horizontal direction at A, vertical direction at A, horizontal direction at B, and vertical direction at B. So you can find out these 4 reactions using the static equilibrium equation, and you have to take another additional equation. The moment at the crown is equal to 0. So using these 4 equations, you can find out this unknown quantity of the 3-inch arch. 3-inch arch transfer loads to abutments at springing points. So this point is the springing point, this point is the springing point, and this is the crown, and this is the span of the 3-inch arch, and this is the rise of the 3-inch arch. In the 3-inch arch, the load transfer from arch to abutment through the springing points. So this is arch, this is the springing point, and here the load transfer from the arch to the abutment through the springing points. Arch transfer loads to abutment at springing points. The horizontal distance between one support to another support is called span. So this is from this support to this support. So this horizontal distance is called the span. The topmost point of the arch is called the crown. This is called the crown. And the height of the crown above the support level, this is called the rise. So this is the support level and this is the crown. So the height from the support to crown, so this is called the rise. So this is all about the 3-inch arch. So there are 2 types of 3-inch arch according to the shape of the structure. The first one is circular 3-inch arch, and the second one is parabolic 3-inch arch. So the circular 3-inch arch, the shape of the structure is circular, and the shape of the parabolic 3-inch arch is parabolic. So first we'll discuss, so what is the circular 3-inch arch? So coming to this one, circular 3-inch arch. So this is the circular 3-inch arch. So here you see the portion of the arch is your semicircle. This is the complete circle, and this is the semicircle. So here, this is called the circular arch. So here this is the support at A and the support at B. And the radius of the circle is R. This is the center of the circle. So this is the radius of the circle. The span length is your AB. This is your equal to L. The span of the circular 3-inch arch, that is your equal to L. That is the length between the A and B. This. From A to B, the length of the arch is your L. And this is the height of the circular arch. So this is the line. So that is joining between 2 support. And this is the height. This is the height that is from the crown to the support. Crown to support, this is your height H. And this is the radius of the circular arch. So you know from the property of a circle, the radius of the circular arch of span L and rise H, you can find out. How to find out the radius of the circular arch? You see, you know from the property of circle. So here, from this point to this point, this length is your L by 2. And from this point to this point, the length is L by 2. And this is the height H, the height of the circular arch. And this length is your equal to 2R minus H. The diameter of the circle is 2R. R is the radius of the circle and D is the diameter of the circle. So this is 2R. From this to this point, this is 2R, and this is the H. the height of the circular arch. So what is this length? So this length is your equal to 2r minus h. So you know from the property of a circle, so you can find out what is the radius of circular arch. If this length is l by 2 and this length is l by 2, so l by 2 into l by 2 is equal to h into 2r minus h. So the multiplication of these two, this portion and this portion, is equal to the multiplication of this portion and this portion. So here this length is l by 2 and this length is l by 2 and this is h and this is 2r minus h. So l by 2 into l by 2 is equal to h into 2r minus h. So from this equation you can find out what is the radius of a circular arch. So r is here equal to l square by 8h plus h by 2. Then how to find out the coordinate at the point D? So let us take one point in the circular arch. So that point is your D. So the coordinate of the point is your xy. So how to find out the coordinate of the point D? So here you see this is the circular arch and this is the point D. This is the point D. So how to find out the coordinate of this point D? We take A at the origin, at support A, and you have to find out what is the coordinate of any point D. You have to find out the coordinate of the point D. Because this is the x, this is x coordinate and this is y coordinate. So what is the coordinate of this point? D is your x, y. So how to find out this x and y? How to find out the x length and y length? The coordinate of the point D. Because you see from the circle, this is the radius of the circle and this is the angle at the center of the circle. So if this is radius of the circle, so what is this length? What is this length? Because this is theta. So this length is your r sine theta. How to find out the x length? So because you know this length is l by 2, you got this length r sine theta. So what is the length of x? The length of x is your equal to l by 2 minus r sine theta. X is equal to l by 2 minus r sine theta. Similarly, find out the y coordinate of the point D. So how to find out this y coordinate? Because you need this length, y, this one. So you see from this, because from this to this point, from this to this, this is the radius of the circle. And what is this length? What is this length? Because you know this is the radius of the circle and this length is your h. The height of the circular arch is your h. So this length, from this to this, this length is r minus h. And you know, if this is radius of the circular arch and if this angle is your theta, so from this to this is your r cos theta. This is, from this point to this point, this length is r cos theta. So if you will deduct r minus h from r cos theta, then you will find out what is the length y. So y is your equal to r cos theta minus r minus h. So this is, this total length is your r cos theta. This total from this to this, this is r cos theta. And from this to this, this is r minus h. So the y length you can find out. So by taking the r cos theta minus r minus h. This is this one. So y is equal to, after simplification, y is equal to h minus r into 1 minus cos theta. So this is the x coordinate of the point D and this is the y coordinate of the point D. So you can find out the x coordinate and y coordinate using this equation. The x coordinate of the point D is equal to l by 2 minus r sine theta and the y coordinate of the point D is equal to h minus r into 1 minus cos theta. So if you know the coordinate of the point D, then you can find out easily what is the vertical shear, what is the radial shear and what is the normal thrust at the point D. And also you can find out what is the bending moment at the point D. Then coming to parabolic 3-inch arch. So you know what is the parabolic equation. In the case of parabolic arch, taking the springing point at the origin, its equation y is equal to 4hx by l square into l minus x. You know this is the parabolic equation, equation of the parabola. This is parabolic 3-inch arch and here this is the hinge at the support A. This is another hinge at support B and this is the third hinge at the crown. take origin as the support. This is x coordinate and this is y coordinate. Take a point D on the parabolic arch at a distance x from the support and at a height y from the support A. So the coordinate of the D point is your x and y. This is the x distance and this is the y distance. And the take this point D and the coordinate is your xy. So here also you have to find out the coordinate of the point D. This is the height of the parabolic 3-inch arch and this is the length of the parabolic 3-inch arch. This is the half of the length L by 2. This is half of the length L by 2. So here also you have to find out what is the coordinate of the point D. Here you see, if you are taking this is the origin and this is the x length and this is the y length. If you are taking the crown of the origin, so what is the equation of the parabolic curve? This equation x square by y is equal to a, where a is the constant. So you have to remember here, so in parabolic arch, so you can find out the y length from this equation. You can find out the y distance, this y, using this formula. If you know the x value, then easily you can find out what is the y value. So from this equation, you can find out what is the coordinate of the point D. Then after knowing the x and y coordinate of the point D, then you can find out what is the vertical shear, what is the radial shear, and what is the normal thrust at the point D. And also you can find out what is the bending moment at the point D. So when the two springing points are the same level, so what is the equation of the parabola? And when the two springing points at a different level, then what is the equation of the parabola? That we will find out. So first, coming to the if the springing point are the same level, because this is one springing point and this is another springing point of the 3-inch parabolic arch. 3-inch parabolic arch. So here you see, when the two springing point is at the same level, if you are taking crown of the origin, this is the x coordinate and this is the y coordinate. The horizontal length from crown to support B, this is L by 2. And the vertical length from crown to the support B. What is this height? This is your h, small h. So this height is your small h and this is the L by 2. So when you are taking crown of the origin, so take x is equal to L by 2 and y is equal to h. When you will put this in this equation, x square by y is equal to a. So here you will get L square by 4h is equal to a. Hence, the equation is, because a is the x square by y, a is equal to x square by y. So a is equal to x square by y is equal to L square by 4h. So from this relation, you can find out what is the height of the point D. This is the equation when the two springing point is at the same level. Then coming to if the springing points are not at the same level. Here you see, this is one springing point, the support A. This is the another springing point, the support B. And this is the crown of the 3-inch parabolic arch. So here you see, this is the length L1 from crown to the support A. The length, the horizontal length is L1, and from crown to support, the vertical height is your H1. And here, this is another portion of the 3-inch parabolic arch. And here from crown to support B, the vertical height is your H2. And from crown to support B, the horizontal length is L2. The horizontal length is your L2. And the total length of the 3-inch parabolic arch is L. L is equal to L1 plus L2. But this height is your in different level. The height of the springing point from the crown is at the different level. This height is your H1 and this height is H2. Here you see, this is when you are taking C at the origin, the crown at the origin, this is equation. If the crown is taken at the origin, the equation of the parabolic curve is x square by y is equal to a, where a is the constant. Because here you are taking this is the origin. So what is the equation? X square by y is equal to constant. Then x by root over y is equal to constant. Then apply this equation to points A and B, and we get, and what is this equation at the point A and what is this equation at the point B. So apply this equation to the point A and B and find out the relation. The constant is equal to, the constant is equal to x. So when we apply to this point A, so what is the x length? L1, because x is the, when you are taking C at the origin, so this is x coordinate and this is y coordinate. So the x coordinate is your L1, the x is your equal to L1, and the y is your equal to H1. So when we apply to the support A, so L1 by root over of H1, and when we apply to the support B, so here this is the x length L2, and this is the y length H2. So here L2 by root over of H2. So this is from the support A, this is from the support B. And take the addition of these two equation, L1 by root over H1 and L2 by root over H2. That is L1 plus L2 by root over of H1 plus root over H2. So is equal to L by root over H1 plus root over of H2. Because you know the length L1 plus L2 is equal to the total length of the 3-inch parabolic arch. So this is equal to L divided by root over of H1 plus root over H2. So you know this is, so when we apply this equation to the point A, so this is the relation, and when we apply this equation to the point, this is the relation, and for the total arch, this is the relation. So from this relation, you can find out what is the length of the arch L1 and L2. You can find out what is this length. For this segment, what is the length L1, and for this segment, what is the length L2. From this relation, you can find out. So L1, you can find out, is equal to L into root over of H1 divided by root over of H1 plus root over of H2. L2 is equal to L root over of H2 divided by root over of H1 plus root over H2. So using this relation, you can find out what is the length of this portion and length of this portion, L1 and L2. Because you know this height, because this is at the different level, the springing point is at the different level with respect to the curve. So you know this H1 and H2. So then you can find out what is the, and you know what is the length of the 3-inch parabolic arch. Then you can find out what is this portion, what is the length of this portion from A to C and from B to C, this length, L1 and L2. Then, if the load is present on the 3-inch arch, because this is 3-inch arch, so if the load is present on the 3-inch arch, then how you have to analyze the 3-inch arch? So at each end, there is two reaction component. This is horizontal direction and this is vertical direction. And at B is also, this is horizontal direction and this is vertical direction. So there are four reaction components, that is BA, HA, BB and HB. So you know for two-dimensional plane structure, these three are the static equilibrium equation, that the summation of horizontal force is equal to zero, the summation of vertical force is equal to zero, and the third one, MA or MB is equal to zero. MA or MB is equal to zero. This is one equation, then the summation of horizontal force is equal to zero, and summation of vertical force is equal to zero. So this is the three static equilibrium equation for the plane structure, two-dimensional structure. And you have to find out the fourth equation. So by taking this one, by considering the hinge at the crown, so you have to take the fourth equation. That is the moment at the crown is equal to zero. Moment at crown is equal to zero. In this case, the fourth equation is MC is equal to zero since C is a hinge. Using these four equations, you can find out the unknown reaction component, HA, BA, and HB, BB. If the horizontal load is not acting, so that case, HA is equal to HB is equal to H. So when you are taking HA is equal to HB is equal to H, so this case, you have to take the summation of vertical force is equal to zero, and MA or MB is equal to zero, and MC is equal to zero. So you have to take these three equations and you have to find out what is the reaction component. when there is no horizontal loading, so that case HA is your equal to SP is your equal to H, and you have to use these three equations: the summation of vertical force is equal to zero, MA or MB is your equal to zero, and MC is equal to zero. So using these three equation, you can find out the unknown reaction component. So here you see, this is where the portion of the three yards. So this is the support, and here you take a section. And what is the forces are acting on the point D? Take a section here, and on this section, what are the forces are acting? Now consider a section at D. Let B is the vertical shear. You know this is B is the vertical shear. So what are the forces acting on the section at D? So this is the vertical shear is your acting. B is the vertical shear. This is acting, and H is the horizontal shear. Horizontal force or horizontal shear. This is acting, and this is the normal thrust. This is the normal thrust. This is perpendicular to the cross section. This is a perpendicular to this section. And this is the radial shear. Q is the radial shear. These are the forces acting on the section D. So you have to find out, after knowing this vertical shear and the horizontal shear, so you can find out what is the normal thrust, and you can find out what is the radial shear. You can find out the normal thrust and radial shear, because you know, so this is the B and this is the H. So this is the angle theta. This is the axis of the arch, and this is the angle theta. And this is the normal thrust. So how will find out this Q? Or how will find out the normal thrust? The normal thrust, you have to take the component of the vertical shear and the horizontal shear along this direction. Along this direction, you have to take the component of this B and H. So because if this angle is your theta, then this angle is also theta. So you have to take the normal thrust N is your equal to V sine theta plus H cos theta. So you can find out the normal thrust V sine theta plus H cos theta. So using this relation, you can find out what is the normal thrust of the three inch arch at any point D. So N is your equal to V sine theta plus H cos theta. Similarly, find out, so the radial shear. So because this is the direction of the radial shear, and this is the vertical shear, and this is the horizontal shear. So take the component of this vertical shear and the horizontal shear along the direction of the radial shear. So component of B along the radial shear direction, this is B cos theta. Similarly, the component of H along the radial shear direction, this is H sin theta. So B cos theta minus H sin theta is equal to Q. Use this sin convention. So right side downward force and left side upward force is your positive. Positive sense of shear. Similarly, here for radial shear, this is this direction. Right side this direction and left side this direction. So this is the positive sense of shear. For radial shear, this is the sign convention, and for the vertical shear, this is the sign convention. That is right side downward and left side upward. This is the positive sense of shear. Similarly, for radial shear, right side is your this direction, and left side this direction, this is the positive sense of shear. So here take, this is the positive sense of shear. Then using this positive sense of shear for B and for Q, you can find out what is the normal thrust and what is the radial shear. So the normal thrust, this is your equal to, so take the component of this B and H along the normal thrust direction. So B sin theta plus H cos theta is your equal to N. Similarly, take for radial shear, take the component of V and H along the radial shear direction. So here this is V cos theta and this is H sin theta. So Q is equal to V cos theta minus H sin theta. So this is the equation for normal thrust. The equation is your V sin theta plus H cos theta. And for the radial shear, the equation is V cos theta minus H sin theta. So you can find out the normal thrust and the radial shear at any point in the arch using this relation. Then coming to what is the difference between the arch and beam, that is arch versus beam. So look at this figure. So here this is the simply supported beam, and here this is supported, this is support beam. These are the loading acting on the simply supported beam, W1, W2 and W3. and this is the reaction at support A, and this is the reaction at support B. Consider a simply supported beam carrying load W1, W2, and W3. At any cross section of the beam subjected to transverse loading, the structural actions are bending moment and shear force. Because you see, so due to this transverse loading W1, W2, W3, so you'll find out what is the bending moment and shear force at any section. At any section, you can find out what is the bending moment and what is the shear force. What is the structural action of this simply supported beam? So here, that is the bending moment and the shear force. Similarly, take the same span arch. The figure shows a center line of an arch. The same load you are acting, W1, W2, W3 on the arch. At any cross section of the arch, subjected to three structural actions. What is the three structural action? So one is your normal thrust, because at any point in the arch, so there is your acting the normal thrust and the shear force and the bending moment. Then you see, so how to find out this bending moment of this one? Because you know, in this case, in the case of beam, first you have to find out what is the reaction at the support A and B, then you can find out what is the bending moment at any point in the case of beam. What are the vertical transverse load you are acting on the beam? So by considering this transverse load, you can find out what is the bending moment in the case of beam. But in the case of arch, you have to find out by considering the transverse loading and by considering the horizontal loading at the support A. So by considering this horizontal loading, you have to find out what is the bending moment at the section, and from this vertical loading or transverse loading, you have to find out what is the bending moment at the section. So here you see the bending moment at any section, M is equal to MA minus HY. Due to this vertical loading, so this is the bending moment diagram. The red color shows the bending moment diagram due to the vertical loading. And the green color shows the bending moment diagram due to the horizontal reaction. So this is the bending moment diagram due to the horizontal reaction. And this is the bending moment diagram due to the vertical loading. So you have to find out what is the bending moment. What is the bending moment here? Because the bending moment due to the horizontal loading, this is the negative bending moment when you are taking the moment about this point. So due to this vertical reaction, the moment direction is clockwise, and due to this horizontal reaction, the moment direction is anti-clockwise. So the anti-clockwise moment is your negative. So this moment is your, this is the negative bending moment diagram. This portion, this diagram is your negative diagram, and this total is your positive diagram. This portion is your deduct from the total portion. So this is the net bending moment diagram. This is your net bending moment diagram. So this is the moment at the section. This is the moment at the section. So this moment is your equal to MA minus HY. So this MA is your equal to the bending moment due to the vertical loading, and HY is the bending moment due to the horizontal reaction. So this is the moment. So at any section in the arch, you can find out what is the bending moment. Now all are clear. So what is 3-inch arch, and what are the different types of 3-inch arch, and how to find out the vertical shear, then radial shear, then normal thrust, and how to find out the bending moment at any point in the 3-inch arch.